It was not as though she had always been aware of her clothes, or that she had felt particularly uncomfortable in them. It all happened gradually, starting one day after work, when she went into a nearby store to buy a pair of tights. The sizing chart on the tights display had no small square indicating that her proportions existed. She, along with a segment of the population spanning 1 inch vertically and 10 pounds horizontally, were simply not represented. She expressed her frustration with loud, primitive sounds she didn't know she had in her. The next day, she wore no tights to work. It was a small, exhilarating act of rebellion. No one in the workplace noticed. The day after, she wore no slip. And the day after that, no coat. Each day that followed, she let go of another article of clothing. And at the end of each day, she was more herself. She came to realize that others were unable to think of her or see her without clothing. They would dress her in their minds, covering her with expectations and innuendos. They went to too much trouble. One evening in a bookstore, she saw a man reading in the philosophy section. He wore no apparel at all, not a stitch. She stared at him, he stared at her. Try as they might, neither one of them could dress the other. They laughed in relief. And the laughter wrapped them in a pleasant warmth and a sweet smell. As random shoppers tried to dress him in the appropriate relationship, he asked her, "Shall we go out and dine together?" She answered, "Yes, let's." Of course, I have nothing to wear.